Native plants are Nevada's real treasure. They keep the desert alive and blooming. I'm at the Song Dog Native Plant Nursery discovering what it takes to preserve them.
Nice to see you.
Nice to meet you.
How's everything?
Good, how are you doing?
Good, good.
Well, welcome to the Song Dog Native Plant Nursery.
Kelly Wallace is a biologist with the Lake Mead Recreation Area who works with restoration projects here at the nursery.
So what goes on here exactly?
We propagate native desert plant material for restoration projects throughout southern Nevada. We work with federal, state, and local government agencies for any of their restoration needs.
So tell me more about those restoration needs. If there was a fire or they're building something?
It could be for construction projects, any of the disturbed areas, they'll do planting to help facilitate natural recovery. It could be any human-caused disturbance, such as off-road vehicle tracks. So any disturbance we can provide
native
plants.
And you used the word natural. So the idea is that these plants are indigenous to the area, is that right?
Yeah, so they're local native plants that are found here in the desert. That's why we keep a lot of native plant material on hand, so that we have various plants that are more common to different types of habitats, so that if someone needs to restore plants, let's say in an aquatic area, then we'll have plant material on hand for their restoration project.
Nevada has more than 2,800 native plant species. They're better for the environment than non-natives, requiring less maintenance and preventing soil erosion.
About how many plants do you do a year on average?
Right now our operation is relatively small, so I would say right now we're producing probably 10,000 to 15,000 plants a year distributing for restoration projects.
And some of those are seeds that they've given you and others they just ordered the plant?
Yes, so we can provide the native plant material for restoration. We also can grow plants out from seed, or we can use cuttings such as root material to grow plants, or taking direct cuttings from a plant like the stem.
The nursery preserves over 100 types of native seeds and also stores developed plants ready for restoration.
Once we go out in the field and collect our seed, the seed is brought back here to the nursery to be cleaned and dried for proper storage. I'll show you our seed cooler room as well.
After the seeds are dried, they're kept in a refrigerated room.
So our seed cooler room is right this way. It's maintained at 40 to 42 degrees.
Wow.
So one of the ways that we can keep seed viable for up to 10 years is in cool, dry conditions. So this is where we store all of our seed.
Wow, there's a lot in here.
Yes, there is.
Are any of these very rare?
We have some sensitive plant populations. So our seeds are stored in these airtight containers. They're sealed once they're dried, and they're labeled with identifying information of the collection site, the collection date. So that stays with the seed as we propagate it.
Really impressive.
Kelly and her colleagues plant these seeds as needed. The seeds then grow into the greenhouse before they're ready to be reestablished outside.
This is greenhouse number one?
Yes, this is kind of our starter greenhouse. This is where we begin propagating our plants. So from our community flats there, we'll take the little germinates and we'll transplant them into these containers. And we'll let them grow for maybe 4 to 6 weeks, and there they can develop a better root system and establish themselves a little further. From these containers, we'll transplant them to these 1 gallon containers.
Oh, now they're growing up. They got their own place there.
Yes, so they need more room as they get bigger. And we'll typically keep these in the greenhouse too until they get a little bit stronger and bigger and healthier. And then we'll take the 1 gallon containers and we'll put them out on our plant beds where they can harden off or adapt to our local environmental conditions.
The native nursery also removes plants from disturbed areas and takes care of them until these locations are cleared for restoration.
And tell me about these, Kelly.
So we're actually working on the Boulder City bypass salvage right now. So areas that will be disturbed through the construction of the freeway, we've gone out and taken plants that were there, and we will take care of them here at the nursery until the project's complete and the disturbed areas are ready for restoration.
Look at those things. Are they okay?
They are okay. So this is part of the cactus that we've gotten from the Boulder City bypass salvage. And you can see they're actually doing very well. They're flowering and fruiting.
You know, that's got to be, on some level, very satisfying to you that you are maintaining the integrity of the environment in southern Nevada. That's got to feel good.
Yeah, I love working here at the nursery.
If you're a plant lover, you can check out the many volunteer opportunities here at the Song Dog Nursery.
All right, so Kelly, I've been so interested in the plants, I haven't asked you this question. It's been burning in my brain since we started. Song Dog?
So the song dog's actually a coyote, and one of the favorite food sources of the coyote is the mesquite fruits. And so as he eats the mesquite pods, he disperses seeds throughout the desert, helping to repopulate mesquite trees. I guess you can think of him kind of as a mesquite propagator, just as we here at the nursery propagate native plants to help repopulate our desert plant communities.
And you do it oh so well. Kelly, nobody would ever get to see this without you letting us in, so thank you so much.
Thank you very much for coming by.
What a pleasure. Chances are, if you've seen a government restoration project in southern Nevada, Kelly and Song Dog probably had something to do with it. They keep everything beautiful.